Super Mario Odyssey!
Hey everyone, welcome back to Super Mario Odyssey. In this video, we're going to head to the next kingdom, the Sand Kingdom. Okay, first of all, I like this world. It's really fun. The main thing with this one is it's huge. This is like a really big open world. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to try to get all like the main ones. You know, I'll get some side ones. By that, I mean the moons. I'll get, you know, the main ones, but some side ones that, you know, that are in my way. Or, you know, along the way, whatever. And eventually I'll get the rest of them and the purple coins too, because there's purple coins in here as well. But yeah, let's just get started. Okay, the Sand Kingdom. You know, Anakin Skywalker would hate this world because he doesn't like sand. But anyway, let's go over here and activate this. Toast Arena Town. Right, let's talk to this guy. Like Happy said, this place is actually cold. You know, it's a desert and it's like freezing here. But we'll get to the bottom of that. For now, let's get some of these purple coins. Oh, what a nightmare that was. So, when I was playing through this on my non-recording file, I was missing 15 purple coins, and I had to look everywhere for those, like, up and down, left and right, everywhere. And eventually, I gave up, and, you know, I looked up where those were, because, well, I know off the top of my head, three of them were in some spot that I would never have looked, and then the rest of them were just like, oh, I overlooked that, oops. Okay, anyway, this is the shop. You can actually buy some new costumes here, and every shop has one Power Moon, so we're gonna get this. This is actually our first one of Sand Kingdom. Well, that was easy. Okay, you can actually see another one back there. We're gonna get that in a moment. But for now, we have a lot of coins, so let's buy another costume here. Okay, and the employee cap, and then... oh, what was this? Employee uniform. The boxer shorts, I don't have enough for yet, but I'll get them later. Nice. Okay, and this guy, you talk to him to spend your local currency, so it'll be the purple coins, which in this world are upside down triangle looking things. I definitely want to get all of these. So, in this world, wait, how many were there? Yeah. Okay, there's 100 purple coins, and all the things that you can buy in the purple side of the shop equal 100 coins, so you can buy all that once you get all of them. For now, I'm just gonna change back to this. Okay, I think it's awesome that there's a Shiba Inu in this game. You'll see another one later. I don't know if- wait, is that the same one? That might be the same one, actually. It does help us get another Power Moon. Okay, so that one I pointed out, you actually can get it now. For some reason, I thought it was behind a locked door. But it's right here. Employees only, and you can talk to them. They both say the same thing. Imagine this strange man coming to the back entrance of your place of employment and just taking something from you. That's pretty scary. Just like in Cap Kingdom, there's posters for Bowser's wedding. You can take him down if you want. Okay, this guy right here, he's like my best friend because I've found so many Power Moons with his help, because what he does, I don't remember if I talked to him in the last video, but what he does is he tells you the name of an episode in this world. So, you know, a lot of the episode names, they give you clues as to where the Power Moon is. Some of them, not all of them, some of them are still pretty vague, but, you know, he's like my best friend, like I said, because he's helped me out a lot. I've gotten a lot of Power Moons just from his hints. Okay, there's a lot of these coins actually in town. And you know what, I'm probably going to miss some. I did mention this earlier, but you know, if I miss some, I'll find them eventually. Oh, I think I just saw some up there. Okay, this guy right here, he won't talk to you. Well, he'll talk to you, but he won't let you in that entrance until you have the sombrero. So actually, I do have to spend some coins here. Not the sombrero, you need the whole outfit. So the poncho and the sombrero. And there's another Power Moon. And I know there's purple... okay, here. I think I might just have enough already. I know there's some in the fountain, but it's still frozen. Let's go spend that real quick, because I do want to get that before I forget about it. Also, I didn't note this yet, but there are... wait, how many moons are there? Right now on the list, there are 69 moons, and right now, like, before you can, like, come back here and get some other moons that are inaccessible, just right now, you can get 61 of those 69s. You can actually get almost all of them right now. Wait, why did I come in here again? Oh, yeah, that's right. Okay, thankfully, when you start picking up purple coins you haven't picked up yet, it does keep track of the ones that you've spent, too. Oh, wait, I meant to put that on. Ah. Nice, but the outfit is not complete, so let's put on the rest of it. Yeah, when this world was shown in the, I think it was... was it the E3? I can't remember if it was E3 or the reveal trailer, but either way, when this was shown, it was just like, wow, there's never been a world like this in a Mario game. So this is really cool. Okay, no, I went there already. Oh, wait. This right here. So there's three seeds in this world. One is right in front of these pots. There's two more. I'll get those eventually. But those will all hatch into Power Moons. Well, not hatch. I don't know why. They're not eggs. They'll bloom into Power Moons. Okay, so he likes our outfit, so he's letting us in. This part is actually really cool. Dancing with New Friends. You know, it's like I said, this game is just awesome. Alright. I think. Oh, wait, let me talk to him. Okay, anyway, I think I'm just gonna go straight for the first objective, which is pretty much to get on top of that part there. Here's some more Goombas. Apparently, these are Micro Goombas. I didn't think they were Micro Goombas because, you know, in the older games, what they usually did was, like, attach themselves to Mario and prevent him from jumping and, you know, make him move slow, but I guess those are Micro Goombas. I mean, they are smaller than regular Goombas. They're also gold. Well, I guess yellow? Because there are gold Goombas, like, in New Super Mario Bros. 2. So I guess these are actually yellow. Yeah, love the sombrero outfit here. Oh, wait, what? I guess that wasn't done yet. Oh. Okay. Let's get these before I forget. I think there's something else over here. One thing I learned in this world is to pretty much check around every structure because there's probably something like around the back or the side. You know, secret entrance, like a hole in the ground, you know, whatever. But yeah, it's like I mentioned earlier, this world took me forever to complete. And like I said, I'm not even done yet. Like, you can get 61 power moons. Oh, this is quicksand, by the way. You don't die instantly if you go in it, like in, you know, Super Mario 64 or whatever. But you do want to stay above ground. Just keep jumping and you'll be fine. Where is that one? There's something here. But I feel like... I'm not sure if it's that part there. There's a lot of stuff to remember about this world. I'll remember it eventually. Okay, and yes, you can possess bullet bills and it's awesome. Or capture, I keep saying possess. I'm gonna say that a lot in this playthrough. It's the same. It's almost the same. Okay. Now what do I want to do? Oh, you know what? Let's do this. See, I'm trying to remember stuff. Oh wait, it's not here yet. There is one that shows up there. There's like a cage that shows up, and you have to break it. I can get this one though. This is one of those moons that I had trouble finding. But thankfully the bird helped me out with that one. And there was one that was like, I had no idea what to do with it, so I had to look that one up. I'll point it out in a bit. Oh, oops. I didn't want to do that. Thankfully, ground pounding into the quicksand doesn't automatically put you in it. That would have been bad. Okay, you know what? I think I missed some purple coins around here. Yeah, they're right over here. Oh wait, are they here? I thought there were some here. Well, here's a seed. I can take the seed. The only thing is I have to take this all the way back to town. And then there's another... The third seed is... wait. Oops. It's like... Over here, I think? Somewhere around here. Or around here. It's one of those. It's on the left side. From what I remember, I'm probably dead wrong. But I know it's like kind of like in an isolated area. Actually, I wonder if the Power Moon already bloomed the first one. Because they tell you to like come back and, you know, see how far it's progressed, but... you know, it hasn't been that long since I planted that. Okay, I keep getting sidetracked. I'm just like finding other things to do. Oh! You know what? I thought that was the one that is in the middle but on the right side. I kind of just warped like a little ahead. But yeah, there is another one that's actually in the area that I left off. Unfortunately, I didn't activate it before I moved, so... Oh well. Yeah, it's just like Cascade... Wait, I almost called it Cascade Falls. Cascade Kingdom. Once you progress through the world a little bit, then some other things start showing up. Like that caged power moon that I pointed out. It's going to be on that platform there. So we'll deal with that a little bit later. Okay, well, thankfully I did activate the thing over there. Wait, is this... There's a part that has like a part where you can sink down a little bit. Oh yeah, this is it right here. This is also one that I had trouble finding. I mean, I can understand if there's like a crack in the wall or an arrow pointing down. That would be a little obvious. Well, I guess if you look closer, you could see that there's a little hole there. But I didn't see that. So, oh, you know what? There's actually also some stuff here. See, I'm remembering a lot of things about this world, but I know I'm gonna forget a lot of it too. Yeah, those were some of the last ones I got in my non-recording file. Yeah, there was a Sphinx at the bottom there. I'll deal with that a little bit later. Wait, I didn't go down here yet. I'm trying to do so many things at once, but you know, I can only do one thing at a time. Oh, yeah, you can get all four of those in a row. Kind of messed up though. It's so weird hitting a button. Crouch. I mean, you can hold down, which is what I do, but you do have the option of holding down a button to crouch instead. Nice. Okay, there's actually another power moon over here. Oh, I forgot it goes all the way over there. Well, thankfully, we can just... Oh, wait. What? Well... You can actually use these binoculars to float up and take a view of the world. But this one is not that far. If you just capture a bullet bill... Come on, fire! Yeah, you can just fly over here. Okay, well, let's go back over there. Oh, I didn't mean to do that. Okay, thankfully I didn't die or anything. Oh crap, I do have to go up here again. Also, don't you love how the Pixel Mario has the same outfit on? He has like a pixel sombrero and stuff like that. It's awesome. Okay, well I probably missed a bunch of stuff on the way up here, but we do have that Power Moon coming up pretty soon. Okay, I think that might be everything I can do right now. Oh, wait. Wait, is it here? I mean, it's just some coins. I think it might be over here. Yeah. I gotta save up for those, those boxers. Okay. So it's another 2D section. This one's pretty cool because it's on, like, a pillar. You can kind of see a little crack in the wall here. There's some purple coins. Actually, they look blue in pixel form. Or violet, I guess. I don't know. Whoa, that was close. Okay, there's a secret over here as well. Okay, and here is the Power Moon that was highlighted at the beginning. Okay, now we have this up ahead. Those things, I'll point those out. I don't know what those are. They're like motorized arrows, I guess. I don't know what else to call them. Anyway, when you throw Cappy at them, it launches Cappy like farther ahead. You'll see in a moment. Oops. Get the coins. Yeah. Okay, these things right here, I don't know what they're called, but they remind me of, like... There was something just like this in Mario Galaxy. It was, like, another robot thing, too. Gives me nightmares from, what was that one called in Galaxy 2? The last galaxy in that one. Because in that one, there were a bunch of them in a row. And, you had to dodge, like, all their laser circles at the same time. Okay, but these ones, they'll break down blocks for you. Just watch out for these laser rings, or heat rings, whatever these are supposed to be. Onion rings, I don't know. You can't even, like, damage them either. Oh, I guess that stunned him? I didn't know that. Okay, another checkpoint, and these guys are called Moeyes. Do they hurt you? Oh, I guess not. But they're very shy. I guess they don't hurt. I thought they were enemies, but I guess not. We'll get with them in a moment. Also, the first time I died in this game was because of these guys. I thought they'd be safe in the poison water. They're not. They, like, you just die, if I remember right, if you go in the poison water with them. So, their special ability, they can put on sunglasses, and they can see platforms that Mario can't. Oops, let me disembark here. So there's actually a platform here, it's just you can't see it with your own eyes. You have to see it through their sunglasses, I guess? You know, I thought these guys would be enemies the first time I played through this area. Because in Super Mario Land, they had Moai heads as enemies too in, jeez, what kingdom was that? They had kingdoms in that game too. But there were different Moai heads too. And, you know, I wasn't sure if these were the same guys, I guess they're not. But that's still pretty cool. Man, that's so scary. Yeah, the Moais can't jump, so you have to take those lifts up in order to get to those the top of those pillars. Now, I'm trying to remember if there's anything else here, because I already know that I'm gonna have a hard time finding everything, especially the purple coins. Okay, you know what, that is something, but a little bit later. Oh, we have another moon here. Or moon pendant. I don't remember what they called it. Yeah, when you hit all four of them in a row, you get coins. That's what I was going to do the first time, but I didn't realize I was at that spot. Okay, I have to remember that. You know, I wonder if that's the area that I didn't like. Okay, well, they might not be hurt by cacti, but yeah, they can get hurt by the poison water. So let's go over here. Oh, well, let me get this first. Forgot about this one. You know, I was wondering why those birds were gathered around there. That's why. Actually, there's a... There's a, I almost called it a shine, a power moon that they're gathered around. I guess they just gather around important things sometimes. Never really noticed that till now. Oh, he can even see the coins here that are hidden for Mario. Okay, I thought I saw some purple coins. I forgot he moves faster without them. No Okay, and here's the last pendant, or whatever these are. So now that we have all five, we have a power moon. Okay, so let's run over there. I guess I'll... Wait, I don't... No, I can't grab it as the Moai. Never mind. Let's grab it as Mario then. Okay, and that's the second, I guess, main moon. Okay, had a little mic issue there for a moment, but yeah, we still have plenty more to go. Okay, I'm sure I missed some stuff over there. Let's go over here first, because I know I'm going to forget about it. So, let's go here and see which one this is. Oh, you know what? I know what it is. Yep. Okay, well, this one here... Yeah, there's poison water, and there's some platforms that the Moai can see. So you just have to memorize the path, and what helped me a lot was just memorizing the patterns on the wall, like where the platform showed up. Okay, this is the one I was talking about earlier. I had no idea. Okay, so there's two power moons here. There's one regular one and then one kind of hidden one, just like most of the other hat doors. It's right here. I honestly, in a million years, would never have figured that out. So that was one of the ones I had to look up. Well, now that I see the mission name, it's super obvious. But, that was back when I was trying to, find all the stuff without it. Okay. Yeah, well, this is easy enough because the purple coins are all on that platform. I just have to get back. There we go. I do like how you get a little jump with a hat throw. It's super useful. Okay, and I think there's one more room. Yep. Okay. Now, the only thing is, I don't remember where the safe spots are for the pipe, so I'm just gonna go back. Oh. Okay, well, we're done with that area. That wasn't as bad as, I guess, the first time. I thought it would be worse. Okay, so we do need to go in there, but we have another mission here. This guy, well, might as well talk to him. So he needs three of his sheep to come back, and they're all pretty close to here. There's one that I can't really remember where it is. Oh, wait. I think this is the one that I had trouble finding the first time. In hindsight, he's pretty easy to find. There's one that's, like, already right here. I don't know why he couldn't just grab it himself, but, you know, we'll help him out. So get a power moon out of this. Where was he? I just saw it. Well, I might as well... Oh, he's right near the junk, too. Might as well grab this. Sorry, buddy. Okay, well, we'll... Get him over here. Hey, it's one of those realistic looking guys. I remember in the trailer they showed those guys at New Donk City, and he ended up here somehow, in the desert, and his car is partially frozen. He's having like the worst day ever. Oh, that sucks. Okay, where is that third sheep? Like I said, they're not that far from the ring. I just gotta find him. Oh, there he is. Come on. I wonder if I could fling him in. Let's try it. Oops! Okay, that didn't work out like how I wanted. Actually, maybe I still can. Wow. Nice. Okay, well, I might as well just head inside. And I do want to get rid of these main missions first. Oh, that stop there? We'll deal with that in a moment. It's actually really cool what you can do with those. Okay, now we are inside the inverted pyramid. You can get coins by doing that. And, let's go over here. You know, I thought getting all those coins in that circle would do something, and I died so many times trying to get all of them. You get nothing for doing it, so don't even bother. Unless you want coins. But, you know, you can find coins like everywhere in this game. Over here? Whoa! What? I never knew this. Whoa. What is... What? Oh. I mean, I knew it wasn't like a collectible or anything, but you know, that's good to know. I had no idea the first time through this level that you could do that. I said this in the previous part. I mean, going through these levels again, you know, I'm finding new things each time. Okay, this is a gravity part. If you've played Super Mario Galaxy and Super Mario Galaxy 2, you probably remember stuff like this. It's no different, really. Actually, it might be even easier since you're, like, flat. You know, holding down a button to crouch actually isn't that bad. Okay, but we're gonna go over here. Is this the outside part? Yeah, this is the outside part. There's some secret stuff here. I mean, shouldn't be any surprise. A lot of these flat 2D parts have secrets. This one's no different. Oh. Actually, I'm gonna get healed here. Is another moon? I hope I can keep that 6, because there's a part later on that I might need them, but, you know, if you die, then you just lose all 6. Okay, I ducked down because, yeah, whatever. Anyway, these 3 right here were a nightmare for me to find. I had no idea those were there. So those were ones that took me a while to find. First time through, I had to look those up. Now, we can break these down. You don't have to break all of them down. But you do want to break the one over here down, if you need this. So make sure you position your camera to where you can see them, because they can sneak up on you, and it's pretty dirty. Okay. You know what? I might do this now. There's actually a secret area here. I'm pretty sure you can access it now. Yeah, when I did this, I was like, you know what? I wonder if this leads somewhere, and it definitely does. Look at this. Lots of coins, Hey, we can afford the pair of boxers now. Okay, the hidden room in the inverted pyramid. Oh, we need another bullet bill now. Come here. Yeah, you can shake the Pro Controller to go super fast. Or whatever controller you're using. Oops. It's a good thing I didn't dive off, because that was not a good dive. Okay, we can get a few more coins here. Actually, let's do this. Oh, I didn't line those up right. Ouch. Man, it's crazy how fast the coins disappeared in Super Mario Sunshine. I keep mentioning that because, as a lot of you know, I uploaded some of that before this game. But they disappear after like 2 or 3 seconds, or they start to disappear. Oh good, we have another heart. Well, you know what? This looks like an area for a boss fight, and it sure is. The only thing is... Okay, never mind. Yeah, there's some stuff you can do here, but I think it's after the boss fight. But I do want to get these. These were three that I also had trouble finding before. Well, let's go in. Okay, she's a little bit more tough than the previous boss, but she's really not that hard either. You can actually beat her pretty easily if you can position yourself right. There we go. You can knock her hat off an easier way, but it takes a little bit more time because you have to wait for her to throw a few more bombs. This part too, you can actually... Oh, I forgot they leave behind the trail of lava. And you can actually interrupt this attack too by hitting her with a bomb. The only thing is, all this lava is here now. I hate that laugh. Ugh. Oh, I thought I got her there. Oh well. Well, now I gotta deal with all this on the ground. Oh, get her! Okay. Okay, well, everything's still frozen. Oh, I missed these two. But once we go through what's going on over there, then all this stuff will be thawed. Okay, well, let's, I guess, just head over there. Also, it's nighttime now. It actually looks really nice at night. Ugh, these guys. They remind me of the Stall Children from Zelda. They act like the same, too. I honestly thought their animation was exactly the same. But, yeah, I mean, you just run away from them. You're really gonna hate them after there's a mission with them that you have to defeat them. But for now, we're just gonna ignore them. This right here, these purple coins, we'll have to get later. We need some help for that one. Actually, I wonder if we can do that now. Can't remember. Oh no, not yet. It's not yet. Never noticed that little light there, and it has a sombrero on it. That's awesome. Alright, oh, here goes nothing. Ugh. Ah, man. We'll see what happens here, but I had some trouble with this one before. And the main problem with this one is just, you know, there's ice everywhere, so you're going to be slipping and sliding. At least until you transform. Because transforming in here, yep. It actually helps you out a lot with moving around. Should we transform now? Oh, you know what? I do have to wait. Let's activate this chain reaction thing here. But, oh, wait, wait, wait. No, Goomba. Okay. I didn't want him to die. But yeah, like Cappy said, the Goomba's shoes prevent them from slipping and sliding around. So that's really helpful. We do want this Goomba because we need this Goomba stack here. Oh, no, wait. Somehow I managed to reach that. And so as you can see, there is a moon here, but we need to be stacked up, I think, a little bit higher. Ugh, I can't jump with these guys. Yeah, even with the high jump, you can't reach that. Okay, so what we need to do is recruit these Goombas. Wait, what? Ah, I guess I had to jump on them. Okay. I did the high jump. There we go. You want to keep the Goomba Tower, though, because there's some purple coins over there that you can see on the left side. You need to have, like, a high Goomba stack to reach them, too. I don't know if you need to be this high up, but, you know, it's not going to hurt. Okay. Wait a minute. Oh wait, you know what? Never mind, never mind. There is another moon here. But it's up there. Okay, I think we can... Oh! I didn't know I could just go up here. Okay, I need the bullet bill. So watch out that it doesn't hit that, top thing. Okay, what we want to do is go over here first. You can actually see this from, like, when you land. Get a stack of coins here. Nice. And be careful when you want to go across this. And right after I said that, I almost fell off. Okay. I think it's safe now. I don't know if I'm facing the right way. Okay, there we go. Oof, okay. There's another power moon. The only thing is, I want to go back, because... Oh wait, do I want to go back? Maybe not. You know what, I was thinking of a different room, so yeah, we can just proceed this way. I mean, honestly, all you're missing is just driving a bullet bill through those pillars. Okay, but yeah, we're getting out of here now. Oh boy, yeah, this part is actually pretty cool. There's obviously a boss fight coming up. And I'm an idiot because I jumped off. I thought, I thought the arena was like right there, but no, it's not. We need to be a bullet bill, and then use that to go over there. There we go. Now we're here. What's up? Okay, so yet another Nintendo boss with a big head and two big floating hands that you fight. Wait, this part is cool. You have to punch him in the face. There we go. With his own fist. But yeah, there's so many bosses in Nintendo games that are like this. I mean, off the top of my head, you have... there's a boss like this in Wind Waker that you threw the bombs in his mouth. Tiki Tong from Donkey Kong Country Returns, that's another one. Andross. There's a Kirby boss like this too. I know I'm missing some. Oh wait, no, never mind. I was gonna say in Super Mario 64, but that didn't have a face. Oh, you wanna make him punch the ice. And quickly possess it and punch him in his own face. You wanna go around that other hand because he's just throwing ice like crazy. But yeah, this this type of boss has been in a lot of Nintendo games. Let me know if you can think of any more. I mean, those were ones I just thought of off the top of my head. Ooh. Oh, he got me. Here, punch this. Oh wait, not yet. Not yet. Okay. I didn't want to die because you start over. There we go, right in his nose. Okay, we're not gonna check that yet. I mean, obviously we have enough. You can see in the top left. But here's Uncle Amiibo. Okay, I didn't need that. Well, unfortunately, that's not working. I don't know what is going on. I did have trouble scanning that Luigi amiibo yesterday. I don't know what's going on now. Okay, but for now, we're gonna look for more Power Moons and the rest of the purple coins. So this is Jaxi. You only have to pay him once, so you can actually ride him throughout the desert, and he's really fast. Let's take him over here. You can hit B for brakes. And you also run into cacti. You actually need him to run into a certain cactus in order to get a power moon. Oh! Okay, I actually did want to run into that. We can get this the safer way. There we go. I did want to go over here though. Well, first of all, to check out this side. Oh! The bird is here! Come here! Yes, I got it. So that bird randomly floats around this area. Sometimes it takes a while, but he eventually goes down to where all these birds are. Actually, these birds are gathered around this. But yeah, that bird, I was very surprised to see that right now. Sometimes it takes a while to show up here. But this area, this desert oasis, actually looks really nice. There's some purple coins here, and there's a Lakitu over there that we're gonna possess him in a moment. Hello. Okay, well, the thing with him is you have to use him to fish out this big cheap cheap. Ah, forgot. You have to cast it before he sees you. Otherwise he just swims away. There's smaller ones here, they're not important. But when he bites the line, just hit A after it. Then hold back on the left control stick. Oh, and mash the A button too. There we go. Okay, we're not done with him yet. There's actually another Cheep Cheep that we have to fish out. I was actually trying to use him in other parts of this world, and I came over here. This is the first time I played this world. And I came over here and I was like, oh, there's a Cheep Cheep in here too. Well, you'll see what it is in a moment. Thankfully, these fishing missions aren't like, for example, Sonic Adventure, like with Big the Cat. When I saw this, I was like, oh no, I have to start fishing. This really isn't bad though. Come here. Oh, I reeled it in too quickly. Oh, got it. Hey, that wasn't a Cheep Cheep at all! Yeah, it was Captain Toad. I don't know why he had the silhouette of a Cheep Cheep, a big Cheep Cheep, but he has a power move for us. Also, if you leave Lakitu here, he starts casting down in the sand. Or, you know, wherever you leave him, like in the grass, I guess. Anyway... Oh, wait! Can't forget about you. Ow. Hang on. Let's activate this. He can actually use one of these too. Sorry. Keep thinking you could possess him, but you can't. Oh, oh no, no. He breaks. Oh, here's something you can do as well. So this statue here looks like him. Yeah, that was nice. So yeah, oh, oops. We can actually use him to cross the poison waters. Oh, the bird. Oh, I don't think I'm gonna reach it. Maybe. No! Oh well. I guess for now I can grab these. Okay, and then there is a challenge here that it's a lot easier with him. Where is the, oh, here. So, yeah, normally you just run across as Mario or whatever, but, Oh, oh no, oh no, oh! Ah, man. I was trying to turn around, but it was too late. Is he still gonna be here? Please be here. Oh. Oh. That was the last checkpoint. he is not here. Shoot. That's okay because I know there's a, you know what? We did see that earlier. There's a Jaxie stop over here. I pointed that out earlier. That's how you can call him. Where is that? Oh yeah, it's right here. Yeah, if he's far away, you can call him here and he'll come to you. Cool. Oh, the bird. Actually, I wonder if I can cut him off over here. I know he flies around to this side. Come here. Aww. Yes. Yeah, one time I hit him and he actually was hit over the poison water, so I had to grab him with Jaxie. Alright, you know what? I shouldn't have him face a different way. How about right here? But yeah, you can cheese this by just getting on his back and just running to the other side. There we go. I mean, you just gotta beat the clock. I'm beating him with a Jaxie. Okay, well, now what do I want to do? There's a lot of stuff left to do. Look at all this. Okay, well, I can try to find that one cactus that I need Jaxie for. See, sometimes I see those hills in the background, I think they're part of, you know, the ground here. So, I'll run off. Oh, it's this one here. Okay. Cactuses. I thought the plural of cactus was cacti. Oh no! The only thing is, he's in a really bad spot. I don't know how to get on his back without running off immediately, so... I think... Oh, there's a Jaxie stop here. Well, I haven't been in here yet, so I might as well go in. Oh, this part. Okay. This one's not too bad. I mean, I hope you like driving the bullet bills, because you're going to have to do that pretty much throughout this whole maze. Hey, don't worry about getting all those coins, because you don't get anything for doing it. I mean, you can do it like this. But yeah, I'm just gonna get out of here. Well, I don't know if I like this camera angle. It's safer to just blow yourself up there. Actually, I think you have to, because if you start timing out here, then you're pretty much dead. Okay, we're gonna take this over to this side, and I think there's a hidden moon here. Oh yeah, the side path. Okay, and we're gonna take this one out the main way, but I'm probably gonna- Oh no! See, I shouldn't have accelerated. You have more than enough time to get to the platform without accelerating. That was just me being stupid. Okay, well... And look, I'm doing it again. I'm just like used to it, I guess. Okay, well, I don't have to go that other way, so I can just go over here. Follow this around. And then follow this around, and then we're pretty much at the end. Okay, now we're done with the bullet bill maze. Let's get out of here. Oh, we're on the top part. Cool. That's good because there's some stuff to get here. You know, every time I see a lizard like that, I keep thinking of Breath of the Wild, how you can... Oh, that's gone forever. I can, like, attack them. What? I've never seen one do that before. Okay, well, I can't really cheese this one, but this one's pretty fun to get. You have to roll for it. And wall jump. Oops. Oh no. Oh no, no, no. Yeah. That was close. I still got it. Okay, well, I'm pretty much doing things in whatever order now. Let's see, do I want to go over here? I'll go over here. There is some stuff to do up here. One of these is a really weird one. I thought you could do it earlier, but you have to wait till now. I think after you beat the boss, it's available. Is it this one? Nope. There's one that has like a shining tail. But maybe... that's weird. Oh, it's this one. Okay, I knew I wasn't crazy. There we go. Actually, you can see those birds flying on it too. You know what, from now on I gotta pay attention to those birds because, you know, I didn't really know what to do for that one. Okay, actually, there's a Jaxie stop up here. Which I thought was weird at first, but there is a reason for this. So let's call him. This one's really random too. I hope I can do this without overshooting it, because I've done that before. I've completely missed this spot. But you want to get him here. Cool. Yeah, I guess he... I don't know what the story is. I guess he used to be a statue like them that didn't move. And now he does. I don't know the Jaxie backstory here. What? What? Let's try that again. I think I got cheated out of that one. There we go. Man, how many do we have now? I'm still missing a lot. I mean, I have a lot, but... still missing a lot. Oh, you know what? Our plants probably hatched by now. Although I still am missing one. I haven't picked up one yet. And I still need to find that one guy. There's a guy here that... wait, where is he? Oh, I still haven't gone up there yet either. Oh, you know what? Let's do that. Oh, can I land on this? Actually, I probably could have, but yeah. Oh yeah, that picture there, I'm not gonna mess with that now. But I didn't do this yet. Let's go in here. So this was shown at E3. I remember this quite well. you're pretty much gonna have to ride Jaxie through this, like, poison river maze. And, it's actually pretty fun. I mean, if you mess up, then you're dead. I mean, no pressure there, but it's actually pretty fun. The main problem I have is with the braking. I don't know... okay. I don't know, like, the perfect timing for the brakes. Okay, this right here is, like, a hidden mission. Oh, you know what? I missed the one. There's another one like this where Lakitu is. I meant to do that earlier, but I'll go back for it. There we go. So that's one moon here. Okay, I need to get those two coins, but I don't like this spot. Okay, he can only break for so long too. If you hold it in, he's gonna start running eventually. No! Well, you know what? I did get the hidden moon in this area and then those coins, so it's not too bad. Oops, I didn't mean to break immediately. Okay. Actually, let's go over here. More coins there. I mean, the only thing you miss on by not going like the main way is just regular coins. Okay. So, you know, like I said, it's pretty fun. Again, if you mess up, then you're pretty much dead, but it's a pretty fun area. If you have a lot of coins, it's not a huge issue. And, you know, I mentioned this last time, but, you know, the fact that there's no extra lives in this game, it's not really a big deal. I mean, the coins replacing it just, you know, you're gonna have a lot of lives anyway, so... you know, whatever. It's all good. Now, I need to get up there, but I honestly can't remember how to get up there. I mean, I know how to get up there, but I don't know, like, what to do, because there's somebody you need to meet in order to get up there, from what I remember. And I haven't met him yet. But I guess in the meantime, I can go back to the Lakitu part and get that, the thing I missed over there. At least I know where that is, it's very easy to spot. So over here... Oh yeah, there's a music note. So you can probably guess what you have to do here. Grab the music note, grab the other music notes, you get a moon. The thing is, you have to be careful not to fall off. There we go. Cool. Okay, well, now what? There's so much to do. There's still so much to do. I guess I can go over here. Where is that? There's something over here. Oh no! No, not over here. It's not over here. It's definitely not over there. There's like a cliffside that has three purple coins hanging off of it. It's such a weird spot for them, but... You know, it's there. I thought it was on that side. The other thing, for this area, you gotta check, like, everything. Oh, there's some purple coins that I missed. Okay, yeah, these ones you can just climb up here. Wait, where am I? Okay, so in this corner up here, on the basically on the top right of the map, we have three more purple coins. How many more am I missing? Okay, well, I'm still missing a lot. Wait, have I done this yet? Let's check this out. I think I have... Oh, no, I haven't. Okay. This part kind of sucks. Where is he? Okay, so you need to find that guy. I mean, he's hidden, but I can see him now. Then you need to use him to shoot coins at these guys. And you just need to defeat a bunch of them. The only thing is, this part is kind of difficult. I really wish I had 6 hearts here. Because he's... Look how slow he runs. And they run actually faster than you. Or almost as fast. Oh my gosh, there's so many of them now. Oh, man. Oh! You know what? That's weird. I got that faster than I thought I would. I guess there's a specific one you have to hit because... my first time through this level, I had to go through so many waves of these guys. But yeah, that's actually where we fought the boss, so that's pretty much all we have left to do in this area. Let's get out of here. Yeah, I'm just gonna warp out. Yeah, like I said, there's nothing left to do in that area, but we... Where is that one guy? Oh, I never did this! So we've seen that... Wait, have we seen that girl Goomba before? I mean, I have, but obviously. Oh, you know what? I don't think she was there yet. Oh, you know what? We still have... Okay. So much stuff to do. So we're gonna take him and break open this cage. I did mention this one earlier. Actually, let's warp over here. There is a stack of Goombas that we can make at the entrance to the ruins. So we're gonna do that and then meet up with a girl Goomba. Yeah, in order to meet her, you have to, have a stack because you can't reach her without the stack. You just have to watch out for like enemies and stuff like that. Wait for me, no! Ugh. Also, you don't want to go in the quicksand with them because they sink. I think... Hang on. You know what? No, I've never been in the quicksand with them. They might not sink, but I don't want to find out either. There she is. So yeah, she just wants to see... I guess... the Mario Goomba? And when she sees him, she gives him a Power Moon. So when you do this, yeah, she gets scared. So let's continue what we were doing before, which is just randomly finding stuff. I got that one. This one here... I think... Oh, oops. I'm pretty sure I could just fly to that one with this. Oh! Jeez. What a surprise. Okay, just more coins up here. Actually, I'm gonna use this to get back here. Oh, I want this. Oh, man, I thought I threw my hat in time. What's next? Well, I guess I'll go into town and I'll get the seeds here, because I know those have... Oh, I didn't get these either. Actually, there's a few more things I could do here, because some of the stuff was frozen. Okay, desert gardening ruin seed, and then this one's desert gardening something seed. Plaza seed. Then there's one more, which is somewhere over here, I think. There was like this area you drop down to, and it's just chilling down there. I actually saw the area before, but I don't remember from where. At least I'm not on Jaxxy, so I'm not gonna fall off as easily. Oh, you know what? It's over there on the left side. I think it's over there on the left side. I remember it looking like... Oh, yep, there it is. That's the seed we need. Okay, the only thing is we have to take this up to the town again. So, just have to be careful not to... get rid of it by accident. Actually, I'm just gonna go towards that. Cause that's kinda near the town. Okay. Well, after this we have... I'll check on what we're missing. Also wanted to check on the recording time. This has been going on for a while. I mean, I did mention this is a huge world, so I'll be doing this for a while. Still not sure if I'm going to make this two videos or not, but if you're watching this now, then you already know. So we're going to throw that in. Oops. We're going to throw that in. There we go. And we'll visit that later. But we can go over here. Oops. There we go. Okay, this rocket ship was frozen earlier, so now we can take it and go up. Yeah, this part here kind of reminds me of Super Mario Sunshine. It's like one of those areas. Like, you can't use Cappy right now. Oh my god! No! Oh! I mean, it would have been pretty epic if I did land on that platform after all, but Okay, I'm not gonna roll down this anymore. I was going too fast. Okay. So there are some purple coins in here, and there's also another moon other than the main one. Okay, the purple coin should be... Oh yeah, there's two right there. I think there's five total here. Oh, that was close. Oh, okay, that was close. Nice. Okay, the hidden moon is actually over here. You know, the first time I went through this part, I saw this at the end, and I was like, because I had to go backwards. It is possible to go backwards from over there. It's just kind of annoying. Okay, yeah, those three coins are kind of tough to grab. You do want to wait for this to, like, flip over all the way. I mean, that's the easiest way to get those. There we go. Strange neighborhood. Alright, that should be it for this part. Okay, we get him back. I think I'm missing, what, five purple coins? And then... I'll have to check on the moons. I see a moon just, like, staring at me from over there. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So it looks like 15. Oh, I'm missing 7 coins. It's more than I thought. But, oh well. I mean, I'll find them eventually. Oh. Oh, you know what? Oh, there's one right here. That one's weird too, but when you see the mission title, you're like, oh, that's what I was supposed to do. Alright, Jaxi is there. Where is that bird? I actually want to talk to the bird. I know. Oh, you know what? Let's do this. So, we're going to walk up to the pup. I did mention he leads us to a moon, and he's going to take us there now. There's actually another moon that's not that far from here either. Come on, buddy. Where is it? Thanks, game. I didn't know how to do a ground pound yet. Also, it's really cool. You can actually play with the dog. Throw Cappy and the dog will bring it back to you. The next generation of gaming is here. This is actually really cool. Not even, like, just playing around. This is really cool. Also, I tried to do a little challenge of my own and just see how far I could take the dog. I took him kind of far, but, you know, it's nothing really. He'll eventually go back to where he came from. Alright, so we're gonna go over here. This is another moon. If you have HD Rumble on, it makes finding this one a lot easier. It's like right here, I think. Yep. The HD Rumble, like with the HD Rumble, it starts shaking more when you're in that spot. Okay, well, how many coins? 7. Okay. I know 3 are on that one cliffside part that I keep talking about. But those other 4? I'm not sure. Gotta find that cliffside part first, though. No, I think I've been here already, so it's not here. No, wait, it is here. If I remember right, these were the last three that I found the first time through. Oh! Why did he grab the ledge? Okay. I think I might take Jaxie over there. It's just the part with a bunch of cacti. So, once I see that, I'm just gonna dismount, because otherwise I'm gonna run off again. Wait, where is it? Oh, no. Sorry, Jaxie. I'm so sorry. I'm sorry. Oh, you know what? It's over here. Okay, I think I just need to, like, tiptoe off the cliff, because you can definitely grab the ledge. Like, I thought you could just throw Cappy at them, but you can't. You better grab that ledge, Mario. Yeah, now I'm missing four, and like I said, it's kind of up in the air where those are. See, the main thing is I haven't found, there's a character that I still haven't found yet. So I need to find him first. I just gotta remember how to find him. Let's warp. Because I'm pretty sure once I find him, I'll get at least, I know one moon off the top of my head. And then, wait, I warped to the wrong spot. And then I'm pretty sure I grabbed some purple coins from him too, or using him. There he is! Okay, this is Glidon. This part is actually really cool. So with him, you can actually glide over by holding B. So he doesn't fly, he glides. Or Fallswood style, you know, whatever. We do need to get over to that stop, but I think we might have to fly back. And then glide down. I flew the wrong one again. I keep thinking it's this one, it's that one. The tower. I just gotta remember that, the tower. I did that so many times my first time through here. I just kept flying that one. Okay, I'm pretty sure he can reach this. There's a checkpoint there too, which is good. No purple coins here. You know what? I thought there were purple coins up here. There's this. So much treasure. Okay, so I'm missing number 11, 27, 29, 40, 41, 44, 45, and that's it. Oh, and 50 through 52. So there's still more to go. Oh man. I'm just trying to think, where haven't I gone yet? Oh, I haven't gone over there. Oh, you know what? Let's go back to the tower. I have to remember it, the tower. Actually, I wonder if I could have just flown over here with Glidon. Oh, I just barely made it. Okay, and that island. Oh wait, you know what? I don't think you get, yeah, you don't get that one now. That's what I think that's one for later, because I don't remember grabbing that one at all. And I've also been here. Oh, you know what? I didn't do that yet. Also, I just remembered one of the moons I haven't gotten yet either. The only thing is, this part's pretty scary. I do need a Moai, though. Hey, come back! There we go. I forgot they can't run. They can't run those ones over. Oh no! Oh man. Oh wait, where do I start out again? Ah, crap. Of course, I can just warp over here. Okay, so yeah, that P-switch is actually something that shows up, you know, not initially, but a little bit later on, once we did some stuff. Yeah, grabbing this is kind of tough. Oh wait. I don't know why I didn't think to just walk on this as the Moai. For some reason, I thought this was elevated, so you had to jump off that. So, man, that's a lot easier than I thought it would be. I was just making that more difficult for myself. Alright, let's warp back to town. Okay, here's Takatu. Let's talk to him and get a hint. Once I see the name, I probably know what I'm supposed to do. Walking the desert. Okay, never mind. I don't know what that one is. Such a, like, a broad, you know, mission titled. So, I mean, I think I know which one it is, I just don't know where it is. I gotta find, there's like a specific cactus that you have to find. Oh, there we go. Oh, it's this one here. Okay, so this is near the fishing spot. Well, it's back there, but this is the one. I don't think this is the one I just asked the parrot about. Yeah, wandering cactus. So this is not walking the desert. Oh, wait, I never did that. Let's do that. The Koopa Trace walking. So, I got 100% on this on my first try. I don't know if I'll be able to duplicate that. But you just walk in a circle. The only thing... Well, you'll see. Watch, I'll get less than 100% this time so you guys don't believe me. So these disappear. So... Hang on, I think I messed up a little bit. Oh no, that... I did mess up a little bit. 88. I mean, you don't get anything for 100%. I just thought it was insane. So, if I didn't mess up on that part right there, would have gotten 100. But, I mean, 88, that's higher than what you needed for the Power Moon. Wait, did I go in here yet? Oh, I did not. Okay, this one is interesting. I think these were the purple coins I've been looking for are two. Yep, there's two of them right there. I'm pretty sure the other two are here as well. I think what I missed back there were just coins, so it's okay. Yeah, there they are, the last two purple coins. No, I don't want to climb back up. Just... There's a Goomba over there too, so... We'll be able to use him to not slip around. Oh wait, no, that's not a Goomba, never mind. There are no Goombas here, so... We're stuck with Mario. That looked like a Goomba from far away too. Okay, so from one of these two, like, as long as you're in between two of them, I'm gonna wall jump up here. And the first time I went through this part, I thought it was, like, finding some kind of shortcut. So I went over here, and I was like, oh, there's a reward! And then I jumped down. You don't want to jump down. Wait, can I get over there? How did I... I did it, but I don't remember how I did it. Oh, like that. So yeah, lots of coins. The only thing is I have to go back over there and wall jump again, because there is a power balloon on top that part there. Man, I've been playing for like an hour straight just talking. So I'm starting to lose my voice here a little bit. And there it is. Okay, Ice Cave Treasure, and then is that the only one? That can't be the only one. Wait a minute. Which one was that? Ice Cave Treasure. Well, that leads us up here. I thought I had to float here, but you don't. Okay, we're back in town. Let's check on our seed. Oh, it's ready. Nice. That's another one. So we're almost done. Thankfully, we're almost done. I mean, I said at the beginning of this video, I love this world, but there's a lot to do in it. It's a lot to do. So we're missing 41, 44, 51, 52. So only four more. You know, it's funny because I pointed out this one earlier in the video, and or maybe in the last part, I don't know how I'm dividing this yet. And I was like, oh, I'll come back to that one, I won't forget. Yeah, I forgot. So this is Sphinx. Okay, so what does Bowser want from this land? The ring. Okay, so once you answer his question, you can go inside and you can get some cool stuff. Lots of coins and a power balloon. Hey, I just noticed the guy in the background is the boss that was here. Except he's gold. Interesting. Okay, we're not done with him yet. You can actually talk to him again. And it's just more riddles. Okay, so for Jaxi, 30 coins. I like that last answer because it was like a billion or something. Traveling by car, what stopped his journey? Ice. I mean, the only other one was sand, but it was ice that his car got, you know, because you remember his car got frozen. Oh, this one I don't remember. Oh, you know what? It's five. I knew it was one of the last two, I just couldn't remember which one it was. What a weirdo. Okay, none of these are like even plausible except for the last one. And also, his name shows up except for that part, so. Yep. That is another Power Moon, so. We're just missing, I think, two more? Yeah. Okay, we're back in town. I don't know how many times I've walked past this area because this is where a Power Moon is and it's just out in the open. Again, this is like super easy to spot and I totally missed it. Yeah, you have to play slots. So after the heart, there we go. Okay, you can play again, but you can't win another moon. I mean, I think if you win the moon, you just get some coins. All right, but now we're just missing one. Oh my gosh. So that one is That one's literally right in front of the parrot. So, again, he's my best friend. So, he's helped me out a lot. Okay, so you have to use HD Rumble to find this one. It's actually in this corner here. There it is. Okay, I think that's all of them, unless I skipped one. Yeah, that should be all 61. Cool. Finally done. That took, I think from the timer on my recording, close to 2 hours. At least an hour and a half, I think. But man, there was a lot to do in that one, but we did that, you know, as much as we can, 100%. But, you know, we went through what we can now, so we're done here. Well, actually, let's go back and go to the shop. I actually do want to buy the stuff I didn't buy yet before we go. Give you more coins. Okay. I think, well, where's the shop over here? Okay, so we're gonna get what we can with the local currency. Well, all the stuff with local currency, because we have all 100 coins now. We had to buy the sombrero and poncho earlier because those are required for Power Moon. Okay, and then the cowboy outfit and the cowboy hat. Might as well change now just to take a look at it. I'll have to look into that amiibo problem because, you know, I'm putting the amiibo on the right thumbstick and it's just not registering. So that's not right. I can definitely afford this now. I'll wear that later. Okay, and we're done here. So let's go back to the Odyssey. I'm just gonna walk there, or jump there, I should say, because it's just right here. Okay, so once you get to the map here, you actually have the choice of going to the Lake Kingdom or the Wooded Kingdom. I'm just gonna pick the Lake Kingdom because it's the first one on the list. But we're not gonna get there yet. You know, I hate to, you know, stop the momentum, but we do have access to the Cap Kingdom again, so we're gonna get there next time. And then also, because the Cap Kingdom is kind of short, you can't get to all the stuff in this kingdom yet because, you know, there's stuff that's not there, you know, until later. We will go back to the Cascade Kingdom because there's actually some Power Moons that we can get now, but we're just going to do that in the next video because this video has gone on long enough. Or if I did split this up into two videos, you know, they're two parts, so yeah, we're going to get there next time. Okay, everybody. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time for the Cap Kingdom and the Cascade Kingdom. I'm gonna go to those two next time. Alrighty, see you then.